My name is Quentin Lucas, and I am the mayor of Kansas City, but I am one small part of what has been a gargantuan project to bring a new front door to the people of Kansas City, to everyone in our region in Missouri and Kansas. You'll hear from a number of speakers today, but we want to make sure that we have a chance to recognize so many who have been important in this project, including our outstanding workers on the project. If you were somebody who worked to make this new terminal happen, please wave and let's give them a round of applause. It is fair to say that it has been an exciting time in Kansas City. An NFL draft coming soon, NCAA March Madness, World Cup 2026, and of course, the Chiefs just keep winning Super Bowls. So we are proud to continue that celebratory spirit in Kansas City today as we open our new KCI terminal. Before I step aside, allow me to speak a few words about some of the important people who are on stage with us today. I thank so many of my colleagues who I've served with over the years, particularly on the City Council of Kansas City. If my City Council colleagues, both current and past, could please rise and be recognized. Thank you all so much. I also feel like I should give up my seat for someone I've known for some time, who is an exceptional leader for the people of Kansas and our entire country, Congresswoman Sharice Davids. Thank you for being with us. And on the stage with me today is someone who, from the time that he became mayor, he saw that this needed to happen. Through a number of different discussions and meetings, battles, and hard work, Mayor Sly James never lost sight of how impactful this new terminal could be for Kansas City, how important it was for our workers, and how vital it was for our future. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a round of applause for Mayor Sly James. So we have a few speakers. We promise we won't be here all day, so I will start with our speakers, the first of which today is Jeff Stryker, the Senior Managing Director of Edgemoor Infrastructure and Real Estate. Since we broke ground on the new terminal on March 25th of 2019, Edgemoor's commitment to Kansas City, our local partners, and to helping build our future workforce has been clear. Their successful workforce training program has made a well-paying career in the construction industry accessible for hundreds, no, thousands of Kansas Cityans and folks from Missouri and Kansas. And if you did not catch it earlier, I'll say it again. We are on time, in fact, a day early, and on budget. And if you are wondering about anything, there have been challenges along the way. A pandemic, supply chain issues, workforce challenges. Jeff and his crew have found solutions every step of the way to build an outstanding facility, but more importantly, to build careers and a workforce for Missouri and Kansas of the future. Ladies and gentlemen, Jeff Stryker from Edgemoor.
Good morning, everyone. Secretary Buttigieg, Governor Parson, Mayor Lucas, thank you for those kind words. Members of the City Council here in front of me and other elected officials here today, Lieutenant Governor Toland, and all the new terminal project partners and supporters. What a historic day for Kansas City. What a fantastic day. As a developer for the new terminal project, I've had the privilege of working alongside the outstanding men and women of this project team for more than 5 years. I am proud to stand up here and say, together, we did it. Today's ribbon-cutting ceremony is the culmination of years of planning, development, design, financing, and construction. It's a testament to the hard work and the exceptional craftsmanship of the more than 300 companies and 6,500 members of the workforce who comprised our project team, and it's the start of an exciting new journey for this region. Forged through teamwork, determination, and a shared commitment to delivering exceptional results, This new terminal is proof that great projects are built on great partnerships. Together, we accomplished what many thought was impossible. We would not be here today without our partners at the Kansas City Aviation Department, led by Pat Klein, our design build partners, Clark Construction, the Weitz Companies and Clarkson Construction, as well as our designer, Skidmore, Owings, and Merrill. I'd also like to acknowledge our incredible trade partners who helped bring this project to life. Through a global pandemic and supply chain disruptions, we persevered, and I couldn't be prouder to say, although the mayor said it already, we were on time, or early, and on budget. So thank you all for your hard work. When we started this project, the mayor and city leaders challenged us to go beyond simply developing, designing, and building a new terminal and deliver something truly transformative for the Kansas City community. We partnered with the city to ensure that significant capacity would be built for minority and women-owned businesses and that we would help to build the workforce of the future. Our terminal workforce enhancement programs, a first-of-its-kind program developed by Edgemoor, supported businesses and workers with training programs, access to lower-cost financing and capital, and other benefits including free transportation services and access to childcare. The project's innovative workforce training program, which was developed together with labor and community leaders and our trade partners, trained 200 men and women for careers in the construction trades. These program graduates worked more than 200,000 hours on this job, and I'm proud to say they earned wages and benefits totaling $6.5 million. Another element of the transformational approach was the aggressive minority business and women business goals set for both local business and workforce participation. I'm happy to share with you that our team not only delivered on our promises we made to achieve these goals, but we exceeded each and every goal we set. So thank you to our partners for that. Transformational impact will forever be the legacy of this project. The new terminal has set a new standard for how projects of this magnitude, when built with intention and in partnership with the community, can serve as a platform for generational growth. In closing, on behalf of the entire Edgemoor and Clark Weitz Clarkson leadership team, I want to express our sincere gratitude for the opportunity to help lead this once-in-a-generation project for the community, and we look forward to our future together. Congratulations, Kansas City, on your well-deserved and world-class new gateway to the world. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff. Thank you, Edgemoor. And thank you, everyone who had a part in the construction of this project. Another reason we are here to celebrate is because every now and then, government gets it right. And good, hardworking local government officials and staff can do real well for us. One of those folks is Pat Klein, our aviation director. He has worked for the city for some time. And he was challenged with not only making sure we got through the political challenges of this project, not only that we got through the procurement of a project, but also that we could deliver an outstanding project. And as I look today, Pat, your work has been exceptional for Kansas City and will be remembered for generations to come. To talk about what the Aviation Department did, ladies and gentlemen, Pat Klein.
Part of good leadership is knowing your role in a group, and you're not here to see me today. So I'm gonna make my remarks very short. First of all, welcome to this amazing facility. Absolutely astounding facility. I wanna thank the 6,500 workers that worked here, and then I wanna thank every stakeholder that had a piece of this project in the last 10 years. And then finally, I wanna thank the community, because this asset is yours, and you've been with us for 10 years, and our staff appreciates it. Thank you.
Our state and federal partners are another vital part of the work that we have done throughout this project. One of our federal partners knows not just this airport, but this community exceedingly well. Having served as mayor of Kansas City and being an exceptional one, and then blessing us with more than two decades of service in the United States Congress. We are proud to have Emanuel Cleaver representing our city, our region, and our country. And we thank you for being here to share words with us today. Congressman Cleaver.
Thank you. Thank you very kindly. Thank you to all of these august leaders. I am pleased to be here. And Pat Klein deserved that ovation and more. This is an amazing job. Actually, there was one of my friends, older preacher, who didn't go to school, didn't go to seminary, and he wanted to start using big words. Money, symbolic words. So he started saying, we got to do something, say something big. And so if he were here, he would say, this is hippopotamously amazing. I want to thank the Secretary of Transportation, Pete Buttigieg, who you'll hear from later, for joining us on this big day. Municipal dreams die when community leaders and political leaders fail to seize the moment. Carpe diem. And the moment has been seized over and over again. This city is on the move. The law of momentum says that an object in motion will remain in motion until it is met with resistant force. And we have the momentum. The public is a part of it, the political structure, the business community. So there is no force out there trying to stop the momentum of Kansas City, Missouri, and the surrounding area. This is a big time deal. And when we are creative, we have unanticipated opportunities coming our way. And I think that this is going to bring other opportunities that we have not even thought about. All of you who've been involved in this must be feeling good today. I hope you are feeling good. And this is a city that should just declare, we will never, ever, ever remain in neutral. Thank you.
Next up, and I've already mentioned him today, but is somebody who wouldn't take no for an answer, was somebody who shared the message of why this airport was so important with the people of Kansas City, with sometimes stubborn city council members. I include myself in that category. And always has a better comeback than you might think. We would not be sitting here today without Mayor Sly James, the help of City Manager Troy Schulte, and so many people who were believers in what this community could accomplish, and who shared with our voters how important this project was, despite the naysayers, despite the questions, and despite concerns along the way. Mayor James, we are proud of all that you were able to do for us. We are proud to have you today. Congratulations, sir, and we'd love to hear from you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I want to correct Crenton. I didn't do things for you. We did things together. That's the only way that we get things done in the city is when we work together. When I ran for office, I ran on with three basic statements in mind. One, go big or go home. I always believed that we were more than what we were. So we build a new hotel. We have the best streetcar system. We put a supermarket on the east side. We built a new airport. We've done a lot of things that people can see. We started Turn the Page so our kids could learn to be proficient readers by third grade. All of those things are important. They were all done by working together with individual groups and people who got things done. The other thing that I learned from my father, was you can't go wrong by doing right. And I always tried to do right by the city of Kansas City. And one of the things that I knew that we had to do right was we had to grow beyond where we currently were so that we could welcome more people from around the world into this great city of ours. And the last thing was improvise, adapt, and overcome from the Marines. And believe me, when you're talking about this airport project, which was like a seven-year pregnancy, we had to improvise, adapt, and overcome. I want to thank a lot of people, and I won't get them all, but I cannot go further without asking for people to recognize and understand the work and the effort that Troy Schulte put into this whole project. Without him, it wouldn't happen. My current business partner and former chief of staff, Joni Wickham, spent as many hours, if not more, on this project than I did. We worked together. We would participate in the late night calls and the long meetings and the handholdings that took place and needed to take place as we went through the process. But then we turned it over to Pat and the people in the aviation department, and look what they did. Look what they did. They came through. They are great, true public servants. They've done things that people said they couldn't do and some said they shouldn't do. But I'll tell you what, all the people who were opposed to this concept at the beginning will walk in now and be proud of it and call it their own. Because at the end of the day, this is what Kansas City needs. I want to thank the people on the city council, the ones that I serve with in terms of Dan and Jermaine for sure, and Lee were there when the first city council. We had our disagreements, but we were all still focused on making sure that we achieved the result that we're standing in today. And thanks to the current city council for following through on the things that were done, and to Quentin, Mayor Quentin Lucas, for being a leader on this issue and making sure that we followed through and got done on time and on budget. But the main people I want to thank are the 78% who voted for it when it came time to vote for it. And that was as a large result of some of the work that Joe Reardon and the business community did in helping us educate people. This is a project unlike any others. This is something that will put Kansas City once again on the map. Just imagine all the people coming through these doors for the draft and for the World Cup. This will be their first view of Kansas City. And when you look at this place, you have to recognize this is the beautiful view of Kansas City that we all want to make sure people leave here with. Thank you all for being here today, and thank you for supporting this wonderful project.
Next, I'd like to acknowledge our vital state partners, and that includes our friends from the state of Kansas, because as we know, this is a truly regional project. And we also know that there is not this new terminal without our Kansas Flyers, our Kansas workforce, and some outstanding Kansas leaders. We thank Governor Lori, that's right, like Sharice Davids. But we also thank Governor Laura Kelly, who I know could not be here today, but with us is Lieutenant Governor of Kansas, David Tolan, who whenever we have called from Kansas City, asking him for support on economic development, on infrastructure investments, on sharing the message of the state of Kansas, of Missouri, and of Kansas City, Lieutenant Governor has been there. Here to represent the people of the great state of Kansas, Lieutenant Governor David Tolan.
Thank you so much, Mayor. And if I may just put this momentous occasion in a regional context, just 3.5 years ago, my boss, Governor Laura Kelly, and Missouri Governor Mike Parson did something that was truly unprecedented. The governors made a decision to compete nationally and globally for new jobs and investment, rather than to compete across the state line. They chose to do something that was hard, that took a long time to pay off, and that held a certain amount of political peril for both of them. But by ending the myopic and destructive incentives border war, those governors and our local partners launched a new era of bi-state collaboration and blew the roof off of what we thought was possible for both states and for the Kansas City region as a whole. And look at what's happened since. Panasonic in Kansas, Meta in Missouri, Urban in both states, the World Cup, the NFL Draft, and Chiefs won the Super Bowl twice. That's no coincidence. We know that every new business and every new resident comes first as a visitor, and they have to have a top-notch experience from the moment they arrive. And now, They will. When travelers arrive at this new terminal, they will be greeted with world-class amenities befitting a world-class metro. And as Kansans, we look forward to helping roll out the welcome mat for the prospective new residents and businesses visiting the region as part of the incredible wave of new growth that is just beginning. And Congressman, you're absolutely right. We have momentum, and it is extraordinary. We're excited about the folks who will attend race weekends at the Kansas Speedway or at Sporting KC's Children's Mercy Park. But it also includes business executives and employees of great companies that are choosing to invest and scale up here, both sides of the state line. Kubota, Meta, Panasonic, Schwann's, countless others. When they land at this terminal, we as a region have a better chance of landing their business and of retaining them in a region that we know they will be proud to call home, as we are. This matters if we're going to continue our historic rise to new heights across the Kansas City region, and let there be no doubt about it, we will. As Kansans, we are so proud that we too will have a first-class experience at KCI, which is the jumping-off point for thousands of Kansans every day. And so we thank our Missouri partners for their vision and their commitment and investment that benefits the entire region. And as Kansans, we pledge to make the most of this new facility and to be good partners in bringing Kansas City to the world and the world to Kansas City. Thank you very much.
So for all of us who are from this part of the state of Missouri or the Kansas City metro area, we recognize that we have not always gotten all the attention from Jefferson City. That changed with Governor Mike Parson, somebody who any time we have called, he shows up, he works with us, and he helps us get amazing, exceptional things done. Governor Parson has been part of so many important projects, including META that was just described, infrastructure improvements, the Buck O'Neill Bridge, and of course, the Kansas City International Airport. He's also a Chiefs fan, which makes us love him even more. Governor Parson, thank you for your support on this project and so many more. Thank you for being with us today, and we'd love to hear your remarks too, sir. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Man, good morning, everybody. What a great day for Missouri and Kansas. I'll even share the stage a little bit. You tell Governor Kelly we miss her here today, but I appreciate you being here, Lieutenant Governor. And, man, what a great crowd. I first got to thank all of you in the vest over there, the men and women day in and day out that make our state so special by going to work every day, building great projects like this, not just here but all across the state of Missouri. So thank you all again. Congressman Cleaver, thank you for your friendship. I know we're colleagues in Washington, D.C. and here, but a little over 4.5 years ago was one of the first people I met was you, and since that time, every time I've made a call or been, you've always been a great friend and great somebody I could talk to and to work with in Washington, D.C., so thank you for everything you do here on that. Thank you. Let me talk about the two mayors. I don't know that I've been on the stage with both mayors from Kansas City at the same time. But I want to tell you, both of them, since I've been governor, have been two of the most reliable mayors in the state of Missouri that I consider that are doing a great job, and I sincerely mean that, have been friends and have been great partners to work with all across the state. And I want to thank them both this morning for all they've done for Kansas City and the relationship to that buck. Matter of fact, speaking of history, Mayor Slay is the only one, Mayor Slay, is the only one that ever told me when I first become governor, and I come to Kansas City and had a meeting with him, he says, Governor, if you're going to be the governor of the state of Missouri and you're going to have to come to Kansas City, you're going to have to step your sock game up. He's the only guy that's ever bought me socks. I don't know if we violated something back then, but anyhow, I've stepped my game up ever since that when I come to Kansas City. So I want to thank that. I also want to thank all the administrators who are up here today that spoke before me, and what a great opportunity for our state. But the last, and one of the things, the other person I want to recognize, because since I've been governor for a while, you know, when federal officials come here, it's a big deal. Because, I tell you why, and you have the Secretary of Transportation here today, and that is a big deal for our state, for Kansas City, for this airport. Because the one thing I will tell you, when you go to places like this and having the Secretary here, he's going to remember this day. And if he's not here, he's not going to remember that. And I think it's one of the highlights, having him here today to be able to speak for all of us and to be able to partner with him to move Missouri forward. So you can throw politics all aside. I don't care about that. All I care about is infrastructure in this state, partnering whoever wants to partner with us and to move this state forward. So, Secretary, I'm very proud you're here today in the state of Missouri. Now, we've all, everybody's mentioned, I mean, how can you not be excited in Kansas City right now? All the businesses coming here, the growth that's in Kansas City, a new airport. We just won the Super Bowl. I know that's been mentioned, but just in case you didn't hear it, I'm going to mention it again. Did you all know that that was the 57th Super Bowl by any chance that we just won? Did you know I'm the 57th governor of the state of Missouri? How about that? I like that. Connections. Then you're not too long, we're going to have the NFL draft here. Can you imagine all the people across the country and the world that's going to come here and the publicity this town's going to get, this airport's going to get? And then you're going to have the World Cup. And then you're going to have everyday people that's going to come here to go to family reunions, to holidays, to see one another, to businesses across the state. And I'm going to refer back to the old military days of the way things was when you joined the military. They'll say the first impression is a lasting impression. Can you imagine the impression people's going to have of Kansas City and our state when they walk into this airport and see what it's like to come here? That, my friends, will be one of the biggest statements we can make, both Missouri and Kansas, for the people to come into our area and how we improve our state and how we move forward in this state. So I thank you all for being out here today. I thank everybody that's had a part in making this very special day. And as always, it is an honor and privilege to be the 57th governor of the great state of Missouri. God bless you, and thank you for having me here today. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Governor. And I always appreciate that he mentions 57. I never mentioned my rank as mayor. I am the 55th mayor. The Chiefs went to Super Bowl 55 but played Tampa, and so we don't even remember that one at all. Didn't happen, ain't worried about it. Our final speaker today is someone who was a mayor himself, someone who understands the importance of investment in infrastructure, of supporting our municipal workers, our construction workers, and everybody who is behind each and every one of these projects, and someone who cares about all of us here in Middle America and in every part of our country. We thank the Secretary for taking time not just to come here to KCI Airport, but to visit with the people who are behind this airport project, the people who are behind the Panasonic project, to visit students at UMKC, and to truly see and support all that we're doing in Kansas City to make this a better region and the greatest place to live in America. Mr. Secretary, thank you for being with us today. Thank you for being part of this important project of the next generation of infrastructure, air travel, and economic development in our region. Ladies and gentlemen, Secretary Pete Buttigieg.
Thank you. Thanks very much. Well, thank you. First of all, Mayor, thank you so much. You have so much to be proud of. The job has only become more demanding since I wore the title. People sometimes still flatter me by calling me Mayor Pete. And I see so much that you have to be proud of, and I know you'll be carrying it on. I want to thank Mayor James, from whom I learned a thing or two when I was cutting my teeth as a new member of the Community of American Mayors. One of those things I learned is that you set things into motion, and sometimes they are completed after you've moved on to another assignment. It must be so rewarding to see this become completed, Mayor. We are surrounded by mayors. I believe that the United States Congress would be a better place if there were more mayors in its ranks, like Representative Cleaver, also Mayor Cleaver, and somebody who is a towering figure in Washington and such an important and effective representative for this region. Thanks for all that you do when it comes to infrastructure. And next to him, Sharice Davids, my good friend, representative from Kansas, somebody who brings such intellect and imagination to her work. And I've known her for a long time, so I would say nice things about her, even if she weren't the vice chair of the committee that oversees my department. But for that reason as well, I'm glad that you're here. To Jeff and Pat and everybody whose teams made this possible. We were talking earlier, there's a new body of research that's come out analyzing billion-dollar-plus projects. The proportion of them that are completed in a way that meets the promised benefits, happens on time, and arrives at or under budget is less than 1%. So you've done something special here that we're all going to need to learn from in this country. Lieutenant Governor Toland, and through you, Governor Kelly as well, we send greetings. Governor Parson, I just want to applaud the approach that you are taking, recognizing that in a world where a city like Kansas City needs to compete with minor cities of 5 million or 10 million people in China that most of us never even heard of, the competitor is not who's over the river. It's a little bigger than that, and that bi-state, bipartisan approach that you have embraced serves your states well, your communities well, and frankly, makes it easier for us in the Department of Transportation to work with you. So we thank you for your leadership and congratulate you as well. And everybody here, what a great day, and coming at such an important moment. This is a historic period of revival and improvement in our country's physical infrastructure. We are underway right now as a country improving tens of thousands of miles of roadway, thousands of bridges, and improvements of every kind in every part of the country. But still, even for a transportation secretary, it is not often that you get to mark a major new airport terminal in America, and that makes this a very special day. Airports are such an exceptionally important part of our economy and our personal stories. As I look around this hall, we all probably think of something a little different as we look around, especially if you worked on it and you think about the piece you worked on the hardest. From the wonderful art that is here to the elegant proportions of this terminal to the functional benefit it's going to have in more effectively moving people in and out from where they need to be. What I think about the most is the stories. The careers and adventures and romances and families whose stories will turn on things that happen because of journeys that begin and end when somebody comes through these glass doors leading into this amazing hall. So many stories will be shaped for the better by this great public works project. And as some of the other speakers mentioned, an airport like this is also the front door to a community, the first impression for millions of people who will come here for work, for pleasure, to see loved ones. And it's certainly safe to say that the new Kansas City International Airport will do that job particularly well. Right now, the air's got that, something I've never experienced before, what I would call new airport smell, which I like. But having seen the proportions of the smoker that's in the barbecue restaurant back there, I think pretty soon there's going to be some other aromas in here. You've got local restaurants featuring some of the best food and drink from the city. You got more gates and a customer-friendly, passenger-friendly design. It's going to help people check in and get to their flights with ease. And it was designed with everybody in mind, with play areas for kids, with restrooms that are accessible and ADA compliant, with baby changing stations, which brings a whole new meaning to me when I think about travel now that I've become a toddler dad. In so many ways, this airport's going to be a model for similar efforts getting underway across the country. And you didn't just deliver the largest infrastructure project this city's ever seen. It bears reporting one more time that you did it on time and on budget and supported over 5,000 construction jobs, including working with 100 women and minority businesses along the way. That's a lot to be proud of. And frankly, these improvements couldn't come at a more fitting time, because we've all seen that America's airlines and airports have been sometimes struggling to keep up with demand. And while the overall picture has improved a lot, there's still a lot of work to do. That means improvements for our airlines and our airports. As you probably know, we've been very, very hard at work on the airline side, holding airlines to a higher standard of customer service. Last year, we achieved a major step up in enforceable passenger service commitments from America's major airlines, getting them to agree in writing to take care of stranded passengers. We put together a dashboard that lets air travelers know exactly what they can expect and demand when airlines are responsible for a delay, things like hotels and meal vouchers and free booking. We've helped air travelers get well over $1 billion in refunds for canceled flights and set a record for enforcement against those airlines that haven't done the right thing. And pretty soon we're going to be announcing a new proposed rule that would make sure traveling parents can sit next to their kids at no extra cost, because that is simply the right thing to do. And it's part of our larger initiative against junk fees in this administration. But it's also a matter of infrastructure. That's why we're here, and that's why we're making historic investments in airports around the country so they can fund exactly the kind of improvements that you've made right here. We have funded a new terminal in Pittsburgh, new gates in Orlando, better bathrooms in Chattanooga, an improvement all the way through to a rural airport in South Dakota that used to be a mobile home, and now their general aviation terminal is going to be a fixed building. We're supporting better escalators in Huntsville, faster security checkpoints, baggage drop-off improvements, check-in counters, customs areas, boarding zones in dozens of airports around the country. It's about making air travel a better and easier experience for everyone flying in America. If you're traveling for work, you ought to be able to find outlets to charge your laptop. If you rely on a wheelchair or have a disability, you ought to be able to have the support you need to navigate a huge terminal. And every traveler ought to be able to check their bags, get through security, and find their gate as easily and efficiently as possible. And that's exactly what you've delivered here in Kansas City. Common sense improvements that anyone who's ever flown is going to appreciate. And I should add that thanks to leaders like Representative Cleaver and Representative Davids, we now have historic funding to continue those improvements across the country, and that is why this will go down in history as America's infrastructure decade. So thank you for recognizing the importance of this work. Matter of fact, through that legislation, under President Biden's leadership, we just announced another $1 billion for airport terminal improvements today, including $6.7 million coming right here to Missouri. We've got, there's an old terminal in, there's an old air traffic control tower in St. Joseph that needs work. Clinton Regional Airport, we're going to be reconstructing a terminal building and the road that leads to it. There's a reason why that legislation passed with bipartisan support, and why leaders from both parties, just as you're seeing leaders from both parties and from all levels of government today, have come together to commit to bringing more good infrastructure to their communities. Kansas City's already gotten funding, $25 million, in fact, not that I'm counting, to keep investing in the airport through that infrastructure package. And there are dozens of others nationwide that can say the same today, from international hubs to small regional and tribal airports. And for so many Americans, whether they are frequent travelers or not, airports are a workplace. They are a source of income, and they are a pillar of the community. For them, this funding means a better workplace. Means more jobs, means a stronger, better connected community. So I am thankful for the tireless work that all the leaders have put into making this project possible in Kansas City, and I'm looking forward to continuing our work to transform airports across the country for the better. Because I'll end where I began. It's about the story. The stories, plural, of the many people who will come here for work or for travel, and how their lives will be shaped for the better by this terrific facility. It's also the story of our country, stepping forward in the awareness that if we are to lead in the 21st century, as we led the 20th, we must have world-class infrastructure, and we will not rest until every corner of the country can say that. Thank you again. Congratulations to this community, and I'm delighted to be celebrating with you. Thanks very much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Secretary. A few final points, and then we'll conclude with this part of the program. First, an acknowledgement and thanks to our United States Senators from Missouri and Kansas, who I know could not join us today, but we appreciate their support, as well as United States Representative Sam Graves, who has been important and vital in the development of this project as well. I'll ask after our comments that the platform party and other dignitaries remain in this area so that we can take pictures and make sure that we officially cut the ribbon. And I will very simply finish with this. Because of this project, thousands of Missourians and Kansans have got jobs and built new careers. Because of this project, we will bring millions, if not billions, of dollars in new economic development to Missouri and Kansas. And because of this project, we will build generations more of exceptional memories here at KCI. And this project is because of all of you. Thank you all so much. God bless you, and let's cut the ribbon. Thank you.